What up, guys? You don't know this is Yanique Curvy Diva, and it's all about GVU entertainment for you.
You're watching The View. The G View on biggonline.com.
Internet TV to the universe.
Welcome to GVU.
Welcome back to GVU TV. Entertainment is for you. That's what we say. And we have Yanique the what?
The Curvy Diva.
Yanique the Curvy Diva.
Oh my God. Yes, I'm here.
Welcome.
You may watch the screen and some mess. My curves and just spread up on the people.
Okay. When we say Yanique, yes, the Curvy Diva.
Yes.
We have viewers like, who is she?
No, I'm not a long time.
Who is she?
Mm-hmm. You mean by women? Let me can't answer that.
Them can't say that.
Them cannot say that.
And why
John,
they can't say that?
They cannot say that. Yanique from Fame FM. Yanique from Magnum Kings and Queen. And you're going to say, who is she?
Viewers, that's why you cannot say, who is she? Yanique. Miss Curvy Diva. Miss Controversy.
Oh, Jesus.
Controversy.
Really?
Everything.
All of that.
Magnum Queen.
Boy.
Talk the things them.
Boy, boy.
Lord God. Give you TV.
I am so happy to be here.
It's so my nice first to have time you here. Here.
Good night, good night, good night. And it's a pleasure to have you on GVU TV.
We're
going
decent.
You stated earlier that you have your own part on the flyers.
Yeah,
so you make for the history.
Exactly. You see, now, history and Curvy Diva right there, so hand in hand, you understand? So I don't know who did there before, and I come talk about all up in an airport and something with him informer self.
Mixed up.
So,
but
not like that happened.
No, man, no. It was just, I mean, it's the first time.
I feel up.
No, sir.
Are you bored?
No, matter of fact, I was giving fashion tips to, you know, one of the officers there. She was like, you know, I love what you have in your suitcase. And da, 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 da. But it was good. It was a nice welcome. So she's like, how long are you staying with us? You should stay longer. I'm like, oh, really?
Well, yeah. Welcome again to Toronto.
To Toronto.
Ali, have some great questions she would like to ask you.
No, Ali, what do you want to ask me?
All right. So Yanique. All right. So we all know it's your first time here in Toronto. Mm-hmm. So how your flight? Well, don't tell me a little bit about it, but you see, I saw mix up.
No, sir. You might talk mix up on something. I'm very informed. And we never ever stay that long in another place. You are wicked. Don't bother come on screen. Your time done. You're not booked for that part here. But from that, I mean, yeah, it was good. The flight was good. Kind of sleep through the whole of it still. And then here we're now landing it. Okay. All right.
It's time to get up, get ready.
But it was good. I mean, everything was good coming through. It was fine. I'm here now a bit hungry. Going for dinner after.
Where are you going?
I don't know.
Try the real jerk.
Logics. Where am I
Bring
going?
Bring her to real jerk. Like, really, really.
Really?
You guys need to take her to the real
Where's
jerk.
The Caribbean, sort of?
Yes, the Caribbean. The same place where Rihanna and Drake shoot the video. But
real
I
jerk.
Must say the food is really good.
Really?
And I'm a belly.
Same
so.
I'm going to go to the work.
Oh.
All right, so Yanique, for the people that not living under a rock and really don't know who Yanique is, tell the viewers about Yanique.
See me for the, boy, who am I? I'm a sweetheart, you know, and I love my dressing room and don't lie that. I'm Curvy Diva, me, myself, Jamaican sensation. You don't know the diva, the queen of diva yet, queen of Captain. No, I'm not
Lord
like that.
Jesus.
I'm just a very down-to-earth young girl.
Yeah.
Enjoy life, love people, love make people laugh. And separate and apart from having the derriere and the this and the shape and all of that, I'm really about character. So once you get to know me, you're going to love me not only for the looks, but for mainly how I am. So yeah, keep it real. I've been in media for all my life because my dad has been like, he was a cameraman, producer, all of that before for like 19 years. So I grew up around camera, grew up around productions and, you know, scene stuff. So it was just easy for me. And then I went to Northern Caribbean University, had a scholarship there, did mass communication. Didn't quite finish, but you don't know. Because Stardust knocked on my door.
And you took
so
the opportunity.
Ready for you. Yeah. All of that. But people stay in a school, done school, everything. You understand? But did that, start working at RGR, Fame 95. That was good for my radio, all of that. But then Magnum called, and I was like, okay, I was kind of dancehall thing, boy, all right, me try it. And I did it, and it's like, what, 7 years now?
Yeah, long time.
Because
you took over from Empress. Yeah.
Right, Empress did, I think, 3 years, right? Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Okay, so let's just rewind a little bit. So when you started out in your first year, I do remember a lot of people were like, who is this Yanique, and she can't take Empress place.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yo, wanna give the girl a chance to not even know what she'll come for bring. So how was that for you?
I love to prepare myself. So in terms of anything I'm going to do, I make sure I plan it out. I make sure I calculate it hard and let me be ready. Because the worst thing is to not be ready and then to go on and, you know, mess up. So when they called me, they're like, yes, you get the job. And I was like, okay, fine. Let me take at least 3 months preparing myself how to do live shows and just to be mentally prepared and emotionally prepared. So when persons come at me like, boy, you can't take Empress, I say, goodie. Big up to yourself, you understand? And just move forward. So it's just about not listening to critics too much and taking it to heart. And really and truly, just don't take things so serious. Like, all right, that's how you feel? Cool, mama. Live your life. Me not help you pay your bills and you not help me. So just go ahead, bill. You understand? So that's how I look on things.
And then we're going fast forward back now.
A piece of something.
Little bit of controversy. Again with Magnum. Earlier this year. Was this year or late last year?
You see, because of you are picking... Are you a started up?
So, you know, you had a little thing with your fellow...
Co-worker,
yeah.
I don't like Skater. A long time, I don't like him. All nuts, I can't stand him. Straight, I swear to you.
You know, send a Skater me at all.
And I don't nuts.
I don't nuts me at all. Poop
at Jesus.
You know what me at all.
Triple.
How was that? Like, all right. A lot of people want to know. Was it a publicity stunt or was it something real?
Oh my God, like, I'm like, gosh, do I even want to, I'm, like I said to you earlier on, like, I'm the only one booked for this.
Okay, guys,
so it never was a publicity stunt, she just don't want to say
no,
that.
No, it wasn't, but I think, for me personally, I can't tell Canada, I can't tell the world, and I have been saying it, it's something that I don't like. I think it was very embarrassing for both myself, and I would assume for her too as well.
Yeah.
So I try not to relive it, and this 10th season is coming up. So everybody be like, oh, what's it going on? It's not going to happen. I mean, if I have my way, it's not going to happen. No dressing room. I probably just want, you know, a little shed or something. Come, I just can't, but I'm not calling nobody around there and telling them to come. No, but it's really about empowering females and just moving forward. It don't look good with cussing and arguing, especially when it's media, it's entertainment, and it's so hard for us. You understand? So before me, I talk, and the man, them just see something else, the boob, and the, you know, they're not paying me the mind. So why, if we're already getting so much stress from society and people and everybody, why not just not have a problem with each other? And that's just it. So, yeah, man.
That's true. I like the I like your approach to it because to be honest, just looking at how you fully approached it, as you said, mentioned earlier, a jovial person, you like to make people laugh, and you took the joke like it was like, okay guys, whatever. Yeah. You were just laughing, like you were fully laughing.
Can't bother. Tell you.
And it takes a big woman, strong woman, to actually do that, for you to actually go back on the show working with her. Oh, like, Jesus. I don't think a lot of people would be able to do it. I think I would have quit too.
Don't you?
Like if Sean this me them way there, G me now come back.
You go host the show yourself. Welcome to GV. Like you just care focus.
Well, yeah. I want beef with my backbook.
Thank you.
Beef with my education. I'm beef with myself to impress some more woman. Inspire some more woman. Bust the blood concept. Good. Thank you.
All right. Can I talk now? Can I talk now? Here's the situation. Hold on. I hear you. I'm not stopping the show. But we never have no beef. That's the point. We didn't. But my thing is, instead of coming on air, how about her dressing room? My dressing room is next to you. And it's been a while. So therefore you're doing it for the public. We do. Kitty, Midis, Yanique. If you have an issue and you want to address that, you can come to my dressing room and say that. All right. Let's continue. Adrian, it's not a show. It's not for the public. You know my dressing room there. Address me. Adrian, please.
Mercy. Poopa Jesus.
Okay.
Never ready.
When I saw that,
yes,
the first thing came to mind is...
You know, it's my first time seeing that.
what happened? What happened? Why didn't they just interject a commercial right there and take you guys off air? That was the first thing. Like, this is crazy.
I don't know if American Idol they go on this show. Please, you know, Mariah Carey and Nicki Minaj, all of them.
What is the relationship now?
If I see her going ogre,
everything good. We have our fight, but then Ali always a win.
Me just tell you what me go do. Me never say everything good. Looks, no, me not, you know what? Let me stop because good. This is gonna actually go in social media.
Right,
everybody is going to say Yanique or Kitty a hug.
We're good.
And then she go when she see me, she go say.
Let's move right along. We're going back to Yanique.
Further on,
go back to Yanique. All right, so Yanique, you have a reality show coming on, right?
Oh Lord, we have one right now happening.
Where are the cameras? So why didn't I come to Toronto?
Because them are at dinner. No, actually, I work for Fever TV here too as well. Okay. So it's a whole heap of excitement. I've been working for Fever TV, which is the first, you know, Fever TV Black station in Canada here. So I've been working for them like about almost 3 years. So yeah, so it's fun stuff. Mm-hmm. I have a talk show on it as well. So. Yeah,
so lots of things in the pipeline.
Holy for things, holy.
So, just tell us, viewers.
What they want to know, I'll fasten my business?
No. We don't want them fasten their business. Your personal life is your personal life. Your public life is public. Personal is personal.
The funniest thing is, I really don't. My personal life is so boring. Like, I just thank God for the public. I love cooking and staying home and just, you know, build with me like one friend so I like two friend them, you understand? And that's about it. I'm a very homebody person. My girlfriend can tell you, if them say, let's go out, I'm not sure, but you see when my go out.
Yeah.
You see, because that's the trick, you know? See, if you regular out yourself and you just go out every minute time, then that is it. So you see, when you're ready for go out now, you're still out. But no, because me real and story team, me no go out, me just all 1 month pass if me no book feed or book for no events. So, and guess what? The month of September was a little easy, me about 3 events. So, you know, me store up all of that.
Energy. Jesus. So, then you're going to let it out in the night. Take it all out.
Everything. Why? You're not ready for me. All of the diva come. You see one thing with foreign though. You see, because I'm not yard and nobody not judge,
yes,
you snap your
girl. Yes.
I'm going
like, yes!
Oh my God! Y'all are, twerk, no! All of that are gone. It's you that ready for it. You for see the frack. I don't know if I can do all of that shaking in the frack.
The frack, I want a new style.
The frack, it have something cover here, something cover here, something cover here. Look what top in the,
Jesus.
But the whole of can't wear weird things with it. Can't wear no
fashion. So Sean, you got the history, right?
Yeah, calm down.
Are you not can manage the heat?
I'm speechless. Like Michael Jackson's song.
Ooh, look.
Curvy. The breakthrough that you get right now in the business. All famous people always venture off and have a look at one record or music.
Really?
Yes.
So that's your advice? Do I look a record? I
may ask if anything.
If I can DJ or I can sing. First of all, you have the talent. All right?
Yeah, no,
so we will see. Speechless.
She's singing better than me. So we know what? Something in other work.
A whole bunch of things. Listen, there is so much in the works. Like, I'm just like, God, can I tell them? I'm looking at John like, can I tell them?
Could you tell us more about this?
Nothing at all.
Could you tell us more about this reality show that's coming out?
My reality show. It's just me doing crazy stuff, actually. We're starting here in Toronto too as well. So it's kind of the Curvy Diva takes Toronto. So I'll be going to different places. I tell them, say, put panelists more, try a strip club.
Oh.
Sorry, this can go on camera.
Yeah, it can go.
I want to see if they can twerk in Toronto. So you don't know, man. Come, strip club and stuff. All of these things. So I'll be touring Toronto and just enjoying myself. That's the first step. And then Dubai and then Greece and then, you know, whatever it is. But then back to Magnum. I remember the 10th season. So it's a big excitement, you know, if I start with a bang or something.
The Magnum and King, somebody. Want to talk about it a little bit.
Okay.
You have a lineup of artists trying to be something. How do you guys go through that channel to skim out like the bad apple or people just you guys use this text?
Well, we have the audition process first. Mm-hmm. We start off with that, which mm-hmm. starts normally is November. So we have the audition process. We go from different parish to parish. So we go Mobe, we go Mobe, Oche, different parishes mm-hmm. in Jamaica. And then we pick about 28 males or something like that. We don't know if we're right. Mm. But whatever the situation. And then through that now, we kind of put them on TV and persons vote. And you vote for who you want, vote for who you love, and that's it. And the judges as well, they play a very important part. All judges.
And
all of them.
Mm-hmm. Is there any time you guys doing, we call it, you know, the squad cutting now?
Mm-hmm. You mean deliberate when the judges go to mm-hmm. deliberate and try to...
Somebody ever cut in the top 10 that way you're like, mm-hmm. how them make it?
No, you know, you see, Magnum, I'm bad you. You understand? So the people that depend on it, them talented. It's like mm-hmm. them really and truly, even last year, them coming like, them have seen DJ long time. Like, mm-hmm. them boss we have album, platinum, bag of things. Mm-hmm. So they're really, really talented people. So I'm really hoping, and I know, this mm-hmm. year we'll expect to see some really talented young people as well. But, yeah, a dancehall music, our culture, that. So everybody ready, you know, everybody come for DJ.
There's so much that go through the Magnum and Queen. Just get mm-hmm. a little bit of fame after they leave.
Oh.
Why is that?
I think for me, they get lazy. And that's honestly it. You get $1 million and you kind of get your money and boy, you get a little popularity and you think that it stops there. You know, but I get no manager, you know, but I do get no booking agent, you know, do not need us to go and enjoy the million and enjoy the hype. But it's going to end soon because Magnum Kings and Queens going to start again and then the new sensation is going to happen. So you really have to put in the work.
Do you get the chance to re-enter again?
Actually, yeah, they do. A whole heap of time. Yeah, man.
If you like, if you win and pop down, no, if you win, would say,
sir, go sit down. You don't get $1 million. Creep. No, man. So once you never win nothing, you don't get $1 million, then you can come again and try again. Enough people do that and then shut it straight through and say, boy, I never stop. I never give up. Yeah, stand.
In showbiz, every show is different. Mm-hmm. I'm always nervous on set.
Really?
Because everything
is
different.
You love it. That's what somebody said to me. Mm-hmm.
How comfortable are you right now on Magnum?
Well, it being the seventh season for me, but the 10th season, really. I'm extremely comfortable. It's so weird. I do get nervous when it starts. Mm-hmm. So when it starts, I walk out. Good night, I'm going to wind up myself a little bit. I'm going to get a little nervous. But afterwards, I'm like, walk in the park. The people them start DJ. So it's fun. I think just be confident and just once you're prepared, that's always my key thing. Once mm-hmm. you're prepared, you read through the script, everything, you just go out there and just do you. Enough time I make mistake, I'm going to go back and say, what me say a while ago?
Right.
It's the Father Jesus. How for name that me call wrong?
A lot of time there people are not paying up the... Mm-hmm. Paying much attention, so it just
no man them pay attention and them done me like a gun. Them say, oh, what did that girl? She carried and she fully. I'ma say, we're not lucky. The last time me check, me get peer before my work.
Curvy Diva in a history party Sunday night ain't gonna be a normal party. It's gonna be happening at La Victoria Banquet Hall. That's a 69 Milvan. Why if it is 69?
What?
69 Milvan Avenue.
That's why it was a secret.
It's going to be Western Road and Finch area. So, me beguno, me can't stop beguno. Go get on a ticket. Avoid the lineup there, gone way around there. So, and then you get frustrated, and then you know, ray. We don't bother with that. You see me, I say? Mm. Next question.
Yes.
From the peeps.
What am I saying?
Is all of that real?
Jesus. People, just check on the history. Real. You understand? Check on the history and see. But put on all the weight.
Them say them not see no 16-year-old picture. You are no 17-year-old picture. They do. With a body.
And them I was like? Very tiny. No, when I was 16 and 17, I was tiny. Mm-hmm. I had nothing. Even when I was about 20-something, nothing. See, I understand? But I'm just like, I blame it on the birth control.
Mix up.
I put on a whole heap of weight though. Apart from that, I put on a whole heap of weight. I plan to lose it. So when mm-hmm. I kind of lose it and then everything start go down and people are going to say, well, I'm going to think, say, yeah, shut up. One of us are going to say.
High school.
Mifta.
Which high school?
Me used to call me YWS at high school because my waist was so small.
Which high school?
Kingsway High is a private school. Mm-hmm. Adventist, I grew up Adventist. Real rigid Adventist, not a joke. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's probably why I'm wild, so. You know, Christian people.
The dancehall fraternity in Toronto is anticipating you hosting this party.
I'm excited.
And this is because they skim through flyers in Jamaica and say, me never see a host one dancehall party yet.
No, hold on. I want to check my Instagram. I have 270,000 followers. And me tell you, the only break me to get in a summer was 3 days. Three whole days. I'm fully booked for every single party. Just book all day. That's the boy I don't know how to use all that. But for each party, I come with something different. Even for Reggae Sumfest, I kick-started Reggae Sumfest beach party. So you understand. So I have two dancers, them, and then roll on pan it, pan the set. I have a DJ, I roll with. All of them couldn't come here, so, but you know, my DJ, them there. Chill it. You understand. You don't understand. So them done there, so them done bad. Listen, I don't just host a party and go on cute. It's not the typical. It's different. My brand different. My flavor different. People come host a party, drink liquor, drink out of the bottle. Hey, what's up? Big up on yourself. Thanks for coming out. Ray. No.
You have hosts that just come and read flyers.
Me not read. What?
What makes curvy different?
Listen, apart from the curves, hunty. Let me tell you, apart from that, I just want to enjoy myself. And it's not even about being bossy, stush, anything like that. Reading a flyer, be like, oh my God, I'm so happy to be here. And you're talking, you know, it's like, hey, big up on yourself. I love it here, Toronto. I come for party. Mm-hmm. I come for sweat off my makeup and sweat out the ear. That's why I make sure I have it straight-ish so it can manage the sweat. And so I'm going to come for dance and go on bad. And then the right people in my place, so you understand. What? And that was a simple party. That was a breakfast party with me twerking. Mm-hmm. A breakfast early in the morning. Party. And then I turn it into, like, listen, I turn it into a water party because the sun started come out. And I said, breakfast. I said, no, sir, I'm going to take a bucket and be it by myself. And all of a sudden, everybody in the party started to show water by themselves. And it was crazy. But that's how you party is a Caribbean thing. Yeah, Jamaican. Jamaican people know for party.
She took the spotlight from Blac China.
Blac China? I need to post them or something. You understand? Perform on Reggae Sumfest, I-Octain. I go up there and I just bubble and drink and out. You need to check your history. The party name history, so check your history.
Oh, you know me like that.
I'm a rhythm now. That's in my car, you know. In my Jeep, you know. We are not. You need for bucket? You need for bucket? Turn it up now. Hold on, man. See, I can't. Hold on. But come off of this, Acheria. The camera have it, everything, the angles, them right. Man, I don't want to move the table. I want to sit down on the table. Hey. Why you look for the people? See, I know what we. Hey. Why you want me to turn around? What about for. I eat stream, I go turn around. I want to come out for the party, come see all of this. I hide it. I'll fight, go.
Hey. What?
No more party.
Yes.
You shall want more history. Logics.
So, social media out there. The Snapchat something. As we said, we had to do the survey. We're doing the survey, and it's like most of the dancehall artists them from Jamaica born a Snapchat.
But. For me personally, yeah, them a bun it out, but me kinda, me not like seeing a man depend Snapchat depend. No matter how much I say I'm a bad man, I don't care. You cannot have Snapchat as, but I worse the filter then. It not, no, you don't do no dog if you.
It don't look good.
Which filter go fit him? No filter, no there for fit him. No, me can't rate you. The man with the filter, me not care if you go snap everybody else around you. Me not know. Snap does not fit the man then.
What? You get the killer them crazy.
But if it's for the ladies. Watch out. A little clip on. Like, girl, what I want to do to you now, sir.
We have a topic tonight, and we're asking all the stars and popular people and famous people that's in the entertainment biz. How do you react to new artists approaching you with their product?
Listen, I'm all about support, especially if it's a female artist. I mean, know someone can help her in some way, shape, or form, so she don't have to shake nothing, twerk nothing, suck nothing, or anything. Kind of it hard for the female them. Mm. I just make sure I start mama, if the talent there, I listen to it, she good, put her through, help her. Of course, definitely. Mm. If it's a male and it sound good, once the talent is there, I'm in full support. If it's not there, I say, boy, brother, you know, say, boy, I don't know if I'm the engineer or something kind of off still. You know, but if I don't know if I'm an engineer, if I'm not, I'm try like a vice trainer. Yeah, man, I'm going to give my advice, I'm going to give my little, you know, number for the vice trainer. I'm mm-hmm. try something. And if I'm going to want better himself, I'm do it. Otherwise, I'm thinking I'll get played.
You used to work on a radio station.
Yes.
And a lot of artists would come back to even GVU TV and say, yo, respect the work. Mm-hmm. You guys bring us here and give us an interview to try push us to the world. And when you go to Jamaica and try to give them a CD they need, they want money for play.
Really?
And I kind of find it crazy mm-hmm. how the you'd have said the facilities are there mm-hmm. to bust out these artists and to try and make them make a living, and they're nothing. Mm-hmm. And this track is, you know what I mean? Crazy thing.
I'm not playing yeah. all of that, and boy, sleepless nights at studios and all of that. But that's where Magnum Kings and Queens kind of come in. You understand? We're not mm-hmm. prejudice to nobody. I sell a bag juice and just decide to come audition, put on your bag juice, or sell somebody watch it, and you just go in front of the judges them and do your thing. There's always an opportunity. Stop, sit down, and kind of be like, you know, say, yo, they want to talk about money and rare. Listen. Everybody True. Stress me and go on. Could I just take the whole criticism and those negative criticism and just say, boy, you know, I'm just going to sit down and suck. No. The girl, all she can do is twerk and this. I'm going to just twerk a little better and put a little music to it. You understand? So I'm going to come out. Yeah. But you just got to keep fighting. That's just my advice. As hard
Yanique,
as it is, fight.
What do you love about dancehall music and what do you hate about it?
Oh, what do I love about dance? All apart from the rhythm. I love the beats. I just like that sort. It's my thing. It's our culture. I remember from a long time, my sister, because we grew up Adventist, my sister now, she used to play the music when mommy now listening to something. When I look back on, she used to, you remember Bubble? I'm watching me. I said, look how she wine and back at the church and everybody praise Jesus. Holy Jesus. We just listen to the drum part. Boom, pa, da, pa, pa. And we start tick to the one that praise Jesus.
Yeah.
You understand? So it's in us. It's our music. Any little thing. It's our culture. It's who we are as a people. And no matter what we try to hide it and all of that. I mean, it's who we are. What I don't like to, I don't know if this kind of say what you say, but I just say it anyways. I don't like the mere fact that people, especially Jamaicans, we're very biased. They're very biased. Soca, you can broke out and tear out and turn out and wear a thong. You go on dancehall party on a battery rider. Oh my God, she's so lewd. How could she wear that? No, girl, you never in a one thong last. Hello? April gone. You never upon the road. Road. Walk up and down upon the road in a one thong. Really? Half naked with two little stickers over your titty. But dancehall is just pushed aside because it's for the people who don't have the sense. It's for, you know, illiterate, all of these things. So I don't like that part. And I think we need to really and truly do something. Even being in entertainment, loving dancehall music, kind of put some knowledge behind it. Come together. It's not a crab in a barrel situation. And that's why when I say, boy, how I feel about the clash and the argument, I don't like it. We didn't have to do it on TV.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the main thing. We are feeding into what they believe is dancehall music. Mm-hmm. And what I hate is I've been in media for years.
Mm-hmm.
But everybody can just come, oh, talk to me about the clash. What to the hello? Look how long me I work. I want to try to tell me, say, mm-hmm. because me go tell somebody, say, my dressing room,
mm-hmm.
me go really and truly get fame because of that?
Mm-hmm.
Really? No. Come on. Dancehall is not about this clash and war and something. Come together, man, and make it right. Get some money right. Everything. May I chat too much? Sorry.
Who is your favorite artist?
Oh, my God. Why are you putting them in the spot? You can't do that. I'm going to go back home. No, I'm not chat to you. You don't know what you said, Beenie Man.
All right. All right. Wait. But we make it easier for her.
Yeah.
Give me your top 10 dancehall artists.
Dancehall
reggae.
I'm afraid, you know why I'm afraid? Because I'm an artist, you know, I'm like, but people that spread rumors say me and him in a thing, so I can't call him
name. Put him in the top 10 if you
want. We don't care.
We don't care.
Listen.
We just want to see if, you know.
My flavor. Yes. Okay.
10.
Spice.
Mm-hmm. 9.
Vibes. I'm trying to. Alkaline. I like Alkaline.
7.
Pop it.
Six.
We're not getting a reel for that one there. All right. But like, Mav music is good too, Mavado. Mm-hmm. There's more, don't it?
Yeah.
Bunty, Beenie, mm-hmm. RDX. For the girl them.
RDX.
So you have two more now.
Oh, Charlie. I like Charlie. Anything for me to go on conscience, anything for me to girl them wine. That's the type of artist mm-hmm. I like. All right? So I'm not too. I like the bad man thing them and the bad man tune. But when we there one party and the please, sir. Please, sir. Flabba. Do not done.
Warning.
No, the worst thing for in our party, I'm gonna give the girl them 2 minutes. The selector him for stop do it, you know. We did and we come there for bubble. We all wear comfortable shoes. I have the little comfy shoes in our handbag. How we're ready for broke out. Good enough for work. And you know, that is the thing.
Who's the hottest artist now?
The hottest female or male?
Both.
Jeez, wanna put me upon the spot? Thank you, Flabba Dabba. Thank you for saving me.
You have the right to remain silent on GVU TV.
Hello.
The war, Mavado PopCaan.
Oh, that was unnecessary. I don't know. Like, listen, my mom said, do not have respect for your elders. Mavado has been in it for a while. So, you hear the twang, where the twang come from? I'm just saying.
Yes.
Like, come on. We do not need that. You know?
Anyway. All said. All said.
Clash again.
All said.
Listen, one advice though for everybody. Mm-hmm. Like, listen, when I come on history, please, people, please, logics make the people them know. When they don't go and stock up, when they don't look for me like say me is a mannequin, you understand? Mm-hmm. Please come over, take pictures, come party with me. If you want a little one bubble, sir, just make me kind of look for you and look in your face to see you don't look like criminal. I'm like, yeah, bubble. Choo-choo.
Yeah, I like you. I like you.
I like that, man. I don't no stick up and go on. No, I can't deal with a stock up thing there and go on like say, mm-hmm. no, I'm come for party, we come for. Come for talk or come for talk.
Social media, if you want to hand it out.
Of course. Yanique Curvy Diva. Easy for fan. Trust me. 270 odd. I want to make it more because we're entertaining all of these. Snapchat, Yanique Curvy. And here's the secret. I will not post too much on my Instagram. All of the things I'm going to do. Mm-hmm. But Snapchat. Lego.
Yeah, Lego Snapchat.
Lego. 24 hours. If you want them screenshot, like, whoo! But this on my Lego. Everything you want to see. Bathroom thing, my friend just come and draw the curve. Snapchat! Ta-da! Ta-da!
People always drop comment when we live in an interview. Really? And somebody dropped a comment and said, if you had to do anything to your body, what change you would make or do?
What kind of question that?
Somebody dropped the question.
Yeah.
We on GVU, we read it out. If you had to do, if you had to do any changes to your body, any change, what would you change?
Honestly, I have a problem. Like, if someone goes on all of man, my little finger, it kind of tear open that way there.
Yeah.
So, I'd probably do surgery on my little pinky finger and kind of bring it in. You understand? So, that's all I said to you. So, any advice no one, I'm going to tell you.
You're well perfect.
You want me on a pinky finger? Yeah. You understand? Just love yourself, man. That's it.
You're well perfect.
And if you want, do a little change to your body, you want to fix up yourself. Just do it. Call your thing. If your teeth twist, you want to straighten it, fix it. If your nose broad, you want to take it in, fix it. I hear a thing, mama. Are your life, you know, you're dead and gone, you know, you're going to regret it, you know, because you know, so you never live it right. I'm not live my life for you, and you don't need to live it for me. Do what you want to do.
Do what you want.
GVU TV, thank you for passing through. Miss Curvy you're Diva.
God, you're going to stone you with the mic. That's it. I don't know what I feel like. I treat me like a dinner after.
GVU TV, keep it locked. On behalf of the cast and the whole of the GVU family, and the viewers, see you guys next week.
Log on to biggonline.com.